Britain's smallest common bird is not, as often believed, the wren, but the goldcrest. Goldcrests are truly tiny, weighing just 4.5 grams, about as much as a fivepence piece, but they are common, lively and pugnacious little birds. Our birds are resident, being found year-round across the whole of the UK and Ireland, wherever there are trees, although they do show a preference for conifers, even isolated ones within broadleaf woodland. Goldcrests appear very tubby and round, with large heads but no necks, and short, fine bills and relatively short tails, adding to the dumpy appearance. During much of the year, goldcrests prefer staying high in the trees, where their shape and calls will identify them. If seen not in silhouette, goldcrests often appear buffy or olive green, with a very open, appealing, or even cute expression. The gold crest on the head, bordered in black, can be surprisingly difficult to spot, although an annoyed male with his orange crest bristling is a real sight. Despite being tiny, goldcrests are active and noisy. They will often initially draw attention to themselves with their contact calls, a three or four syllable zhri zhri zhri, as they hustle about their business. The birds are acrobatic as well, behaving almost like the familiar tit family, hanging upside down and even hovering to glean insects off the very tips of the branches. When moving around busily, the other feature that often shows up are the white spots on the tertial feathers on the back. Goldcrest song is a familiar sound of our woodlands, although notoriously high-pitched and therefore, sadly, one of the first species lost to us as our hearing deteriorates with age. The song is a jaunty, rhythmic, repeating deedly, 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 and finished with a flourish. Our birds are generally resident, but many individuals come to the UK in winter. Coastal falls of large numbers of migrant goldcrests are an occasional and spectacular feature of East Coast birding during late summer and autumn. During the winter, the birds forage in a wider variety of habitats and often join tit flocks. It is not at all uncommon to find goldcrests foraging low down in hedges, where they can be amazingly confiding, seemingly completely ignoring an observer. The closely related firecrest is a much rarer bird. First recorded breeding in the UK in the early 1960s, as a breeding species, it is very much found in the south and east of England, although there are occasional records across most of England and into Wales. Somewhat more common in winter, firecrests are then most likely to be found in the southern half of England and Wales, with a strong bias towards coastal areas and the inland breeding hotspots. Firecrests are ever so slightly bigger than goldcrests, although they weigh the same, giving a subtle, more strung out, less dumpy appearance. When looking at images in field guides, the most obvious feature on firecrest are the black and white stripes on the head. But surprisingly, these can be quite difficult to see in the field, as the bird flits about. One feature that is really obvious in the field, as the bird slips through the vegetation, is a small chestnut patch or thumbprint on the shoulder. If seen well, however, those black and white facial stripes are striking, giving the whole bird an annoyed or even ferocious expression. As firecrest is slightly less dumpy than goldcrest and a more moss-green colour and with far less obvious pale tips to the tertials, care must be taken when seen from behind not to mistake this species for one of the rarer, tiny Philoscopus warblers, such as yellow-browed or Pallas's warbler. As with goldcrest, firecrests are vocal birds and will often identify themselves and draw attention to their presence initially by their voices. The song is not as jaunty as goldcrest, a simple repetition of a single note, usually ending with a simple flourish. The song lacks that rhythmic pulsing of goldcrest. The call, though, is similar to goldcrest, but it is stronger and purer, a sip-sip sound, more emphatic and repeated constantly as the bird moves through its habitat. In the UK, firecrests are found in usually conifer woodlands, or at least associated with conifers during the breeding season, although they are more frequently encountered foraging low down in scrub and bushes than goldcrest. In winter, like their more common cousins, firecrests often join roving tit flocks, but can also be found in scrub and coastal reed beds. An absolute gem of a bird and always worth keeping your eyes and ears open for, as their numbers are increasing in this country.